everyone, and welcome to the KnowZone, the place where we have fun while we learn. My name is Charlie.
Hello, I'm Wanja, and of course, he is Marara. Marara?
Hi, everyone. Are you ready to celebrate?
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. We are in a party mood this week on the KnowZone.
Now, Maspeed is going to be taking us out there, and I think I saw something about celebrations where he was going.
Oh, that sounds like fun, Charlie. And what about the Junction Juniors?
Oh, yes, that's right. Now, we are going to be looking in on James, Nita, and the rest of the gang in a minute. And I think I saw something about celebrations in there as well.
That's right. But first, let's go meet our party studio guests. They're eagerly waiting to meet us in the Chill Out Zone. Hello.
Hello.
Now, why don't you say a big hello to everyone who's watching at home?
Hello.
Now, we're really glad to have you here helping us out with today's show. Thank you so much for coming. Hey, Mara. Where's Marara?
Let's call out for him.
Marara!
Oh, hello, everyone. Oh, sorry I'm late. I had to pick my pencil. I want to write this week's KnowZone buzzwords.
Who can tell us what these buzzwords are teaching us about?
Celebration.
Excellent. Now, what are the KnowZone buzzwords for today?
Celebrate. Party. Gift. Birthday. Ceremony.
Excellent. Did you write them down? Good. Try and listen out for them because you'll be hearing quite a few of them through our next program.
But right now, let's go to Makutano and find out what our young friends are up to on
Junction Juniors!
To us, so we need to make this birthday a very special one. Who has any idea?
I've got it. I'll buy Babu the latest video game in town.
What is it called?
Excuse me, Brian. You can't buy Babu a video game because he doesn't even have a television to play it on.
James is right. We need to buy Babu the gifts that his family needs the most.
What about this radio I'm repairing? When I fix it, Babu can listen to music on it.
Great idea, Bakari.
I've just had a brilliant idea. We can throw Babu a big surprise birthday party. Think about it. Since his mother was killed in the tribal violence, he's had to deal with so much pain and trouble. A big surprise party will make him feel special.
That's a great idea. I can see it. It will be the best party ever. Quick, let's start planning so that we don't ruin the surprise party.
Okay, so who will go first?
I can bake a cake.
And I can ask my grandfather to give me clothes for Babu and his family.
Me, I'll decorate the hideout.
Junction Junior!
It's Babu!
We can't let him see.
Papa!
Password!
Celebrate!
What are you saying?
Celebrate!
Sorry I'm late. So, what did I miss?
Nothing much. We were just talking about
then by
sports.
What's so funny? You're all so mean. I hate you.
Oh no, poor Babu. He thought you were laughing at him.
So, should we go look for him?
I don't think so. We should let him cool down first. I'm sure he'll come back later.
Lelet is right. So let's start getting ready for the big ceremony.
Mm-hmm.
I miss you so much, Mom.
Why are you crying, my friend?
I'm not crying and I'm not your friend.
Oh, that's a shame. Because you look like you could do with some real friends. People who listen to you and be by your side. But since you say you don't want us to be your friends...
No, wait. I was late.
Please, I want to be your friend. Good, but I have to warn you, it won't be easy.
You see, if you want to join our gang, you have to go through special trial. So, what do you say?
Sure, it can't be that hard.
So all of us have a role, yes?
Yeah. Junction Juniors, we all know what we are supposed to do, right? I said right?
Right.
Attention. The time right now is exactly 11. We should be back here at exactly 1. Is that clear? With all the gifts and prizes you have promised to bring. Clear? Go! Now leave! This place could use some Christmas decorations.
Are you ready or are you scared?
Just one sip.
Yes. Just one sip is all it takes to join our gang.
No, don't do it! You know alcohol is bad for you. Who is this? Babu, do you want to join our gang or not?
Give me back my bottle.
No!
Fight!
Someone tell me what's going on here. Home. Now.
And you haven't even started decorating.
Hey, don't worry, Nita. This place will be ready even before now.
Please hurry up, because I don't have much time. Anyway, we just came to check on you. We're going to my house so that my mom can help us bake the cake.
I just can't. It is going to be so much fun.
Drinking alcohol is both wrong and dangerous. And people pressurizing you to drink it are not your friends.
I understand, and I'm sorry.
And you, Brian, you did very well. You should help your friends when you see them go astray.
Thank you. And Babu, I'm sorry we all upset you. We all want you to be a Junction Junior. You're our friend.
But why were you all laughing at me?
We weren't laughing at you, I promise. And if you go to the hideout now, you'll see what we're keeping secret.
Aren't you coming?
I'll find you there. Today's Babu's birthday, and I want to give him something special.
Brian, you are a very good boy, and I'm very proud of you.
Birthday that I forgot it was my birthday. Thank you so much.
Don't thank us, man. What are friends for?
Yeah, what are friends for?
Junction Junior forever!
Yay! Wow, that was such a wonderful episode. Did you all enjoy that?
Yes!
It was lovely the way Junction Juniors threw a surprise party for Babu.
That's true. So did you hear any of the buzzwords?
Yes, I heard the word birthday.
Good.
The password was celebrate.
Great, very good.
I heard the word gift.
Well done. So what have you learned from today's episode? Yes, Juma?
I learned that you should always help others when they are in need.
Excellent. Yes, Amina.
I learned that your real friends should not force you to do the things you don't want to do.
Yes.
Good.
And I learned that your real friends won't force you to join a gang, especially when it means drinking alcohol to be a member.
I think we all know what that means. It means that it's time for cool words.
And welcome back to Cool Words. I hope you've been well. Now, who can remind us what we learnt about last week?
Oh, well, I can.
Yes, Marara?
We learnt about singular and plural nouns.
That's right. Did you remember that? Now, who can remind us what singular and plural mean?
Oh, me.
Yes, Marara, again?
Yeah, singular means only one, like one cat.
Mm-hmm.
And plural means more than one, like 3 cats.
Well done. Now, how do we turn a singular noun into plural? Yes, Adan?
You add an S to the end of the word, so cat become cats.
Well done. That is what we do to change most singular nouns into plural nouns. But there are some singular nouns that you just can't add an S to make them plural.
Oh, now, that sounds very complicated.
Don't worry, it's not complicated. I will show you how to do that. Today, we are going to learn how to change singular nouns that end with S, double S, or X into plural nouns.
Wait, don't you just add an S?
Not if the word ends with S, double S, or X, okay? Now, let's try. Who can give me an example of a word that ends with the letter S? Yes, Idede?
Bus.
Bus. Now, let's add an S to that word. So, what does it become now? Read it for us, Marara.
Oh, that's very simple. One bus, two bus. Hey, wait a minute. It sounds exactly the same.
Exactly. And that's why we just can't add an S on its own. We need to add ES. Now, who can read it for us now? Yes, Roba?
One bus, two buses.
Well done. Now let's look at some other examples which we need to add ES to make them plural, okay? So bus plus ES becomes?
Buses.
Gas, you add ES?
Gases.
Class, we add ES to make it?
Glasses.
Dress, we add ES to make it?
Dresses.
Box, we add ES to make it?
Boxes.
And lastly, fox, we add ES to make it?
Foxes.
Oh, I get it now. Any noun that ends with an S, double S, or X needs an E and an S at the end to make it a plural.
Well done, Marara, you're absolutely right. Now let's play a quick game just to make sure that you've all understood.
Oh yeah, I love games. So how do we play?
Good. Now I have cards here with singular nouns written on them, okay? Now you decide whether we need to add ES or S to make it plural, okay?
Yes.
Good. So here are your cards. So my first word is box. Yes, Juma?
We add ES and it becomes boxes.
So we add ES and it becomes
boxes.
Good. The next word is leopard. Yes, Roba?
We add S, it becomes leopards.
Good. The next word is dress. What do we do? Yes, Juma?
We add an AS and it becomes dresses.
Good. So we add ES, it becomes dresses. And the last word, teacher. What do we do? Yes, Idede?
We add an S and it becomes teachers.
Good. So we add S and it becomes teachers. That was fun, wasn't it?
Yay!
Great. I'm sure you now understand the spelling rule. When a singular noun ends with the letters S, double S, or S, X, you add an ES to make it plural. Now that's all we had time for today. Now though, it's time to celebrate with weddings, plural. You'll see what I mean when you join my speedy in Out There.
Hello kids, come, let's have some fun, come.
A friend of mine told me that there's an interesting ceremony going on here today. Come on with me. Let's go in and find out what's happening. I have attended many weddings in my life, but this is amazing. I have never seen such a big crowd of people. They seem to be friendly people and their culture is beautiful. I would love to make new friends today. Look who is my friend now. Diksha is 6 years old, and just like me, she loves weddings. So we are going to enjoy ourselves. I'm told that more than 20 couples are getting married today. As every bride waits inside, every groom arrives accompanied by his family and friends in a process called a barat. The groom sits patiently waiting, and I think it's a worthy wait. In the company of their best maids, slowly by slowly, the brides walk down. Wow, don't they look beautiful? I love their decorations as well. Finally meets the bride and they exchange a necklace made of flower petals. Towards the end of the marriage ceremony, a ritual called fairy, meaning revolutions, is performed. In the fairy ritual, a part of the groom's attire and the bride's attire are tied together, symbolizing that they are now united. One by one, friends and relatives congratulate the couple by presenting gifts to them. Then they go around the ceremonial fire 7 times. Each round above the fire symbolizes a part of life. Sometimes during the ceremony, the groom puts a little red powder in the parting of the bride's hair and puts a necklace around her neck, meaning that she is now a married woman. All married Hindu women are supposed to wear this necklace for the rest of their married lives. And now that the couples are husband and wife, it's time to have a bite of their favorite cake. I'm sure whoever baked it must have considered that it's a very special day. After the ceremony, there is a lot of food. I can't wait to get my share because I'm very hungry. Thank you. It's been a colorful day. And now it's time to say bye to my special friends.
Wow, now that was amazing. All those weddings in one place. That is what I call a celebration.
Yeah, and when I grow up and get married, I'd like to invite all my friends from the animal kingdom and have a party just like that.
But Marara, every day on the NOUNS is a party.
Oh yes, that's true. But I know something that's definitely going to keep the party going. You know what time it is? It's time for...
Number one!
Right, now, this is a game that we invented to help Marara with his maths.
Oh, please help me.
Now, the game is very simple. Now, on the blackboard, there are three sums, just like this example right here. Now, our number run makes the run across and solves the sum, at which point they need to go down to the number pit, like so, and pick up the number that completes the sum, just like this. Once they have the number that they need to complete the sum, they go back to the blackboard.
When you get here to the board, you need to make sure you put your number in the correct position. Once you've picked this number, you cannot change it. And once you stick it, it's stuck.
That's right. Now, once the number runner has solved the sum, you have to run across to your teammates and tag in the next person, just like this.
You have three sums to solve in just 45 seconds. So we all need to cheer our number runners with the correct answer. Are we together?
Yes!
Very good.
All right. Now remember, in this game, speed is everything. So if you solve your three sums correctly, you get to take these wonderful maths books back to your school. Now, isn't that excellent?
Yes!
Are you ready?
Yes!
Are you sure?
Yes!
Let's have our number run, number one.
Let's put 45 seconds on the clock and reveal the first sum.
6 times 4 is what? Go!
Correct
number!
34! 34! 34! 34!
Go, 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 go!
Tag the next person. Tag the next person.
66 divided by what is 11? Go!
Look for 6. Hurry.
Good.
Next.
Tag the next person.
Tag the next person. Go.
1 plus 55 is 85. Go.
You're looking for 30. Come on. It's right there.
Hurry. You're sure that's your last final answer?
Oh, time up. All right, go back.
Good. Now, let's see if you solve the sums correctly. On to the first sum. 6 multiply by 4, that's what we asked you, is what? You give 24. Is that the correct answer?
Yes!
On to the second sum. We asked you, 66 divided by what is 11? You give 6. Is that the correct answer?
Yes!
Woo-hoo. And on to the third sum, we asked you, what plus 55 is 85? You give 30. Is that the correct answer?
Yes!
Very good. 30 is the correct answer. Let's give them a big round of applause, everybody! Yay!
Now, the big question is, did they solve these questions on time? In the 45 seconds? Oh, I'm so sorry. You did! So congratulations for being the first winners of Number Run on the NOUNS. One more round of applause, everybody!
And congratulations to all of you. You're all winners. And you have helped me with my mathematics.
That's right.
Well done. Did you all have fun playing Number Run?
Yes!
We still have another half hour of fun and learning right here on the KnowZone.
That's right, so don't touch that dial because we'll be right back after this. So let's get this party started. Why don't we remind everyone who is watching at home of the KnowZone buzzwords?
Celebrate. Party. Gift. Birthday. Ceremony.
Well done, everyone. Now, for you at home, we hope that you'll be listening out for these buzzwords throughout today's episode. And if you want to participate in Hot Numbers, make sure that you have your paper circles and your pencils ready.
That's right. Mara, why don't you tell us and everyone who is watching at home of what animal Ranger Rukia will be teaching us about?
Well, I can only give you a clue. This animal is big, very, very big, but lives in water and eats lots of grass.
Do you know what animal he's talking about? Yeah, me neither. Why don't we all go find out together on The Wild Zone?
Hello, KnowZone Rangers. I am Ranger Rukia, and today we're going to meet some very interesting animals called hippopotamus. But I call them hippos. It's easier to say. Hippos are very large mammals that live in East Africa. Did you know that hippos are the third largest land mammals in the world? Only the elephant and rhino are bigger than the hippo, and they only have four toes on each foot. They have very thick skin and almost no hair at all. Hippos can spend all day wallowing in mud when it gets too hot. The mud helps to protect their skin from the hot sun. Even though hippos are large and heavy, they're very good swimmers. They can spend 6 minutes underwater without breathing. Can you see that their eyes and nostrils are on the top of their heads? This enables them to breathe and keep a watch out for predators while keeping cool in the water. Hippos make very good mothers. They protect their babies from crocodiles and lions who may want to eat them. Young hippos can suckle milk from their mothers underwater. Imagine that. A young hippo begins to eat grass at 3 weeks, but its mother continues to suckle it for about a year. Hippos may look very gentle, but they can be very aggressive too. Wow, look at their teeth. Their teeth are very sharp and strong. Did you know that their teeth are made from ivory? Elephant tusks are also made from ivory. Hippos don't use their teeth for eating. They use them for fighting and scaring off any animal or human that gets in their way. Because hippos are so big, they don't have many animal enemies, and they can live to be over 40 years old. Their biggest enemy is us humans. Some humans hunt and kill hippos to eat their meat, or because they want to use their ivory as decorations. As rangers, we try to stop humans from killing hippos. We want to protect them and let them share our wonderful wild world with us.
Wow, I had no idea hippos could hold their breath that long, like up to 6 minutes.
Do you think you can hold your breath for even a minute?
Let's all try. Goodness, hey, stop, don't make yourself dizzy. It's not easy, it's quite tough, isn't it?
Okay.
I don't think he held his breath.
Oh, I held my breath. But, Mara, are you okay?
I'm fine. I made it to 30 seconds. Lions can't hold their breaths for too long.
Well, we all know what that means. It's time for...
Hot Numbers!
Hello and welcome back to Hot Numbers. We are going to have lots of fun as we learn. Are you ready?
Yes!
Great. By now, you're all familiar with what fractions are. Now, who can tell us what a fraction is?
Oh, me.
Yes, Marara?
A fraction is part of a whole number, like a half, two-fifths, or a third.
Good. Now, what do you know about these numbers?
The top number, the numerator, mm-hmm. is smaller than the bottom number, the denominator.
Well done. And what do we call such fractions? Yes, Adan?
Proper fractions.
Well done. Now, how about fractions that also have whole numbers? What do we call them? Yes, Awino?
Mixed numbers.
Well done. Now, today we are going to learn how to add fractions, okay? On the table, I have a circle that has four equal parts. If you have your paper circles, you can join in at home. Now, we are going to add fractions that have the same denominator. Now, who can remind us what a denominator is? Yes, Achieng?
The denominator number is the bottom number.
Well done. Now, when we add fractions that have the same denominator, we only add the top number, the numerator, okay?
Yes.
Now, how many parts do we have in this circle? Yes, Roba?
Four parts.
Okay. So what is our denominator? Yes, Mudasia?
Four.
Good. Now, Idede, why don't you take away three parts out of these four parts? Good. How many parts do we have left?
One.
Good. Now, how would we say this as a fraction? Yes, Omel?
One quarter.
Good. So it's a quarter. Okay? Now, Idede, why don't you put in one part of the circle? Put it right here. Mm-hmm. So what do we have now?
Two quarters.
That's right. Now, Idede, put in another part and I will put my additional sign here. So what have we got on this side?
Two quarters.
And what do we have on this side?
One quarter.
Yes, it's one quarter. Now, if we're to add up all the parts we have here, what fraction would we have? Yes, Achieng?
We have three parts, so it should be three quarters.
Two quarters plus one quarter equals to three quarters. We only add the numerators, which were two and one. So what is two plus one? Yes, Omea?
Three.
Okay, that's right. As you can see, both fractions have the same denominator, and in the answer, the denominator stays the same.
Oh, yes. The bottom number, the denominator is a four in all of the fractions.
Mm-hmm, that's right. Now, Idede, why don't you put in the other part of the circle? So what have we got on this side?
Two quarters.
And what have we got here?
Two quarters.
So what is our denominator? Yes, Achieng?
Our denominator is still four.
Okay. And which numbers do we need to add up? Yes, Roba?
2 plus 2.
And who can tell me what the answer will be? Yes, Mudasia?
4.
Good. And what will the bottom number be?
It stays the same, so it will also be 4.
Good. Now let's put the pieces back together and see how our circle looks.
Hey, it looks exactly as it did when we first started.
Meaning? Yes?
It is a whole.
That's right. Now, when the numerator and the denominator have the same number, it's no longer a fraction, but a whole number.
So, if we saw a fraction that was 6/6, it wouldn't be a fraction. It would be a whole number?
That's right. Now, let's try something else. In front of you, you have your circle that has been divided into 10 parts. Now, I want this group to put in 5 parts of the circle, and this group to put in 4 parts of the circle, and I will place my additional sign there. And who can tell me what we have to do to add this fraction?
Oh, I can.
Yes, Marara?
We just add the two top numbers, that is 5 and 4, and leave the bottom number the same.
Okay, so what is 5 plus 4? Yes, Adan?
9.
5/10 plus 4/10. What is our answer? Yes, Awino?
9/10.
Good, so we have 9/10, okay?
Yes.
Now let me just push this a bit here, and then I will put my plus sign here and add 3/10. So who can tell me what the sum is now?
Oh, I can.
Yes, Marara?
It is 9/10 plus 3/10.
Mm-hmm.
We have to add the two top numbers together to find our answer. So the answer is 12/10. Does that look right? It looks strange. The numerator is bigger than the denominator. Is that okay, Teacher Pendo?
Well spotted, Marara. When the numerator is bigger than the denominator, we call that an improper fraction. Now, the world of fractions is growing every day. Next week, I'll be showing you how to subtract fractions.
Right now, though, it's time for more celebrations. Something a little different. Let's go and find out what's happening in Art Zone.
Training of an acrobat requires much endurance, much effort, and a lot of discipline. A good acrobat for me is that one who will do the most impossible thing on stage and present it in a very simple way with a smiling face, eye contact. For me, that's a good acrobat.
We have a lot of centers that we work with in areas like Dandora, Korokocho, Madare, where we take trainers there.
Nilianza acrobat last year. Napenda kucheza acrobats, zinanipeleka nchi mbali mbali.
The activities here is just by training acrobats, and sometimes even we do some like dancing and drumming. Our future plans is that we see all of the acrobats, that all of them are working, maybe if possible international. We are really working hard to try to train them and to show them the way of how they can live by doing acrobatic or even dance or drumming.
That was so impressive. Did you all enjoy that?
Yes!
You know, I love the fact that they're teaching children how to dance and how to use their talent.
Oh, yes. In fact, I'm going to try some of those acrobatic acts at home.
Oh, no, Marara, don't do that. Now, for you at home, the acrobatics you've just seen are done by professionals. So please, don't try anything you've seen at home.
Now, it's time for something that will get our brains working fast.
Oh, yes, that's right. It's time for a challenge. It's time for Spell It.
Animal. Chapter. Animal. Building. Narrow. Building. Respect. Meter. Deep. Digital. Work. Welcome to Spell It. Idede, Adan, and Achieng. You're about to step out of the shadows and into the light to compete for the top prize of the KnowZone Spelling Champion, in which the winner will go home with their very own KnowZone dictionary.
Now, each contestant has just 30 seconds to spell correctly as many words as possible. If you want to hear the word again, simply say repeat, and the word will be repeated for you. Now, each word is worth 1 point, which means the more words you spell correctly, the more points you have. Are the rules clear?
Idede, you're up first. Please take your place on the spelling zone.
Idede, your 30 seconds start now.
Cake.
C-A-K-E.
Gift.
G-I-F-T.
Guest.
G-U-E-S-T.
Arrive.
A-R-I-V-E.
Wedding.
W-E-D-D-I-N-G.
Friends.
F-R-I-E-N-D.
Decorate.
D-E-C-O-R-A-T-E.
Invitation.
I-N.
Time is up.
Well done, Idede.
Good.
Well done.
Adan, you're up next. Please, take your place on the spelling zone.
Adan.
Yes?
Your 30 seconds start now.
Bake.
B-I-C-K.
Dance.
D-A-N-C-E.
Prize.
P-R-I-Z-E.
Invite.
I-N-V-E-S-T.
Balloon.
B-A-L-L-O-N.
Present.
P-R-E-S-E-N-T.
Ceremony.
C-E-R-E.
Time is up.
Well
good.
Done, Adan, well done.
Achieng, you're up next. Please take your place on the spelling zone.
Achieng.
Yes.
Your 30 seconds start now.
Card.
Repeat.
Card.
C-A-R-D.
Enjoy.
E-N-J-O-Y.
Party.
P-A-R-T.
Attend.
A-T-T-E-D-N-D.
Speech.
S-P-E-A-C-H.
Surprise.
S-U-P-P-R-I-S-E.
Time's up.
Well done, Ching. Well
good.
Done. Now, standing across from me, there are some very nervous faces. So we will not draw this out any longer. I can now give you the results for Spell It. But we'll start with Idede. Idede, although you spelt the word friend correctly, the word that Wanja asked you to spell was friends, which means you did not get that point. However, I can announce that in joint second place, we have Adan and Achieng, which means Idede, with 5 points, is today's KnowZone Spell It champion. Let's give him a round of applause, everyone.
Step forward.
Step forward, Idede. Idede, congratulations. Why don't you show everyone your dictionary? Another round of applause, please. After that very tense competition, why don't we all take a nice, deserved break? It's time for African Tales.
Hello, everyone. I hope you're sitting comfortably. I'm going to read you a very special story. It's about a very, very greedy hyena. Now, don't forget to look out for our buzzwords. So, here we go. The greedy hyena. Long, long ago, in the land of Karofo, the animals and human beings lived together in harmony and even invited each other to ceremonies such as birthday parties and weddings. One such ceremony was a big wedding feast for Mr. Kimata. He was a baker and baked the most delicious cakes in Karofo. He was marrying a wonderful woman, and he wanted to celebrate by throwing the biggest party in the land. Everyone was hoping to be invited to the wedding feast. One sunny morning, while the animals were going about their business, Kestrel came flying past, high in the sky, carrying invitations to the party. He dropped them one by one. "Hey, where is my invitation?" Hyena shouted at Kestrel.
"Mr. Kimata has decided not to invite you because of your greedy behavior at his last party."
And Kestrel flew off to deliver more invitations. Kestrel was telling the truth. Some time ago, Hyena had disgraced himself at one of Mr. Kimata's parties. While the guests were arriving, Hyena had greedily eaten all of the delicious food and left without saying thank you. Hyena looked on at the animals chatting happily about the celebration. He was upset thinking of the delicious food he would miss. The wedding day arrived. All invited animals rose earlier than usual to dress up for the wedding. They made a splendid sight as they walked to the ceremony carrying gifts for the bride and groom. Lion, the king of the jungle, was dressed in a shiny metal crown, and everyone bowed as he arrived at the wedding ceremony. The only one who didn't bow was Hyena, because he was not there. He was watching everyone from a nearby hill. He could smell the delicious food, and it was making him very hungry. His stomach rumbled in protest. Back at the party, everyone was hoping to dance with guinea fowl. The king of the jungle had for long been eyeing her.
"Can we dance, my queen?" asked Lion.
"Oh, yes, Lion, yes,"
guinea fowl replied, smiling. During ceremonies such as weddings and birthday parties, a prize is given to the best dancing couple. No sooner had the lion and guinea fowl begun dancing than the other animals followed suit by joining them on the dance floor. However, no one looked more beautiful or more stylish than lion and guinea fowl. All this time, Hyena continued to watch from the hill, his eyes mainly focused on the table that was covered in delicious food. His stomach rumbled loudly as he crept closer to the wedding. He hoped that everyone would be too busy to see him. But just as he was about to sneak in, he came face to face with Elephant, who was blocking the entrance as the bouncer.
"I'm sorry," said Elephant, "but you cannot come in without an invitation."
Greedy Hyena's stomach went out of control and rumbled so loudly that one could have confused it with the sound of thunder. He walked off, feeling even hungrier and angrier than before, and continued to watch everyone having fun without him. After all the guests had eaten and drunk to their satisfaction, and there was no more food left, it was time for the speeches. Mr. Motomoto was the master of ceremonies, who loved to laugh a lot, and after every sentence, he would burst out laughing. While he gave a speech, Hyena watched him closely. He started to fantasize about how juicy and delicious Mr. Motomoto would taste. The more Mr. Motomoto talked and laughed, the more Hyena's stomach rumbled. Suddenly, he could bear his hunger no more. He burst into the party and jumped onto Motomoto. He started to eat him up, starting with his laugh. It was delicious. He was about to start eating Mr. Motomoto's mouth when, all at once, all the animals and people rose to save Mr. Motomoto. On seeing this, the hyena fled. That is why today, the greedy hyena's laugh can always be heard, which he got from eating Mr. Motomoto's laugh. The end. Oh, poor greedy hyena. Well, I hope he learnt his lesson not to be greedy. That's all we have time for today, but there'll be another story next week. See you then. Goodbye.
That was such a wonderful story. Did you all enjoy that?
Yes!
Did you all have fun on the KnowZone?
Yes!
Well, thank you so much for joining us and helping us with the show. You have all been fantastic.
Come on, everyone. Let's say goodbye.
Bye! Bye.